The following contest is a last man standing match, and it is for the Divas Championship.
What up, guys? Logan's 100 here. Let the introduction start, and then we can get cracking with this match. Summer looking amazing here tonight, if I do to say so myself. The attire, I put it together. Simple and easy stuff, you know what I mean? Nothing too crazy. Nothing Summer wouldn't wear. I thought she'd definitely wear something like this in some point in her career. She might have something like this soon enough, but you never know. I like it, though. I just wish her skin wasn't like a ghoul color, but I don't know what the fuck they were thinking there. But that's every year, so what are you gonna do? Oh shit, it's time. See, there's Summer Rae inviting Yamashita into the ring right now. Like I said, I'll talk more about this match when it starts up, but let these two do their thing. This is for the Divas Championship. What up, guys? Alchemist 100 here. Oof. Already starting this match off nicely. Oh, Yamashita striking back quick. Welcome to Mayhem, ladies and gentlemen. It's been a long time to get to this point. And Yamashita really blending in really nicely with their arena here. I think the mat may be a little too white. Not exactly. I didn't exactly test drive it yet. Oh, but I do like the icy colored stairs and everything like that. Mayhem is gonna be just mayhem. That's what it's gonna be. This is a last woman standing match. And this is her first match of the night as Yamashita defends her Divas Championship against Summer Rae. This is episode 147 to 148. Right now, Yamashita doing so much work. You gotta give some very credit into getting into the head of Yamashita, which is not something easily able to do against a veteran like Yamashita. Oof! Yamashita now striking back as much as he can here. We want to do this quick. You don't want to waste too much time with Samurai, or Samurai can fucking take it to you after a while. Right now, Samurai not getting anything going. Oof! Alright, Samurai getting something going now. Those long legs of Summer Rae, those sexy long legs of Summer Rae may help her a lot in this match. Like I said, not only getting into the mind of Yamashita, but also getting past the body conditioning of Yamashita here. Summer Rae beating the hell out of Yamashita. And not only that, the help of Rachel Raiden also helped her out, injuring her. In an Extreme Rules match a few weeks ago. And it was an amazing match nonetheless, but in the end, oh! Even though Yamashita won that match, she was damn near hurt by the end of it. Yamashita not throwing those fucking headbutts there. Oh! But regardless of all that, Yamashita is defending her championship here. Oh my gosh, right on that table though, that powerbomb reversal. Now somebody taking advantage. There are no disqualifications in this match, no countouts. The only way you can win this match is by knocking your opponent out for 10 seconds. If you can keep your opponent down for 10 seconds, the match definitely is yours. But the question is, who's going to win it? Oh, big time kick right to the fucking chest there. And I'm sorry guys if the ring mat is too white. Sorry about that. It's a lot of shit. but it is done. One of my better arenas, I do say so myself. I do like it a lot. I've had better ones before, obviously, but this one is really giving me a lot of love for wrestling games. Oh my goodness! Right now, Yamashita, setting up like she has the match in the bag here. Right now, she just might. Counting down, Summer Rae here. Referee kind of a little too quick for my taste, actually. Summer's completely unpredictable, so no one knows what's going to happen. And apparently, it'll take a lot. Summer Rae getting herself back up here. Oh, going after the arm there. And like I said before, Yamashita is hurt. Her ribs are injured. And Summer Rae will take advantage of that and do what she has to do to get a victory here. But if anyone can come on top, it could be Yamashita. Yamashita has an experience edge over Summer Rae, which may help her get over that the fact that she has that stomach injury, that she has the midsection injury there. Summer Rae using that little bit of strength that she has over Yamashita to toss her back down now. And you gotta watch Summer Rae. Summer Rae is so damn quick. She can get things going in a matter of seconds. And using those legs there, use that durability that she has, may definitely help her win this one against Yamashita. The question is, can she do it? By the end of this one, we will find out. But right now, these two being the hell of each other. Mayhem features both Pure Intense Wrestling and Divas. But we're starting off here with the Divas championship match. We're in Washington D.C. or by the end of the night, we could be fucking end of the world here. Don't know. We're always in a different location in one night. It's like old school Raw or something. Look at this, Yamashita flying. Oh, landing right on Summer Rae there. Referee coming outside to check on Summer Rae to see if she's hurt. Yamashita moving Summer Rae away from the table. Since they patched that, I can't walk towards the table and press L1. I have to like walk at it and then press L1. I can't do both at the same time. Oh, Summer Rae playing possum, but only for a moment. Oh my goodness, Yamashita with a ladder here. I don't know if that's exactly the best thing they'd be doing here in this kind of match. You don't want to risk injury, and I mean, even though Yamashita's injured, you don't want to risk any more permanent injury. Let's say she comes out the victor in this match. She still has to take on the next opponent. When you're champion of anything, there's always someone going after that championship as well. Oh, and a big-time elbow right to the side of the head. And right now, Summer Rae has not gotten anything going. Oh, and a back-for-back smacking not only off that chair, but you saw her arm. She's going favoring that arm there. It's from smacking off the side of that, the edge, sorry, of that, steel step. Oh! Yamashita is still going here. And you know Summer Rae is going to fight back at some point, but on my own. Ooh! Yamashita could care less about the count at this point. She wants to beat the hell out of Summer Rae. Summer Rae has been giving her more trouble than any other person she's taken on so far in this. Oh! In this season, this year, and I mean, this can be a long season. Also, sorry guys about not putting up videos as much as I can. I have a lot of fucking shit going on, man. So I'm sorry about, videos aren't flying up like they usually do. Like last year, I remember it was getting into the year, and I was just like, I'm gonna put these videos up. I started doing them like, I had two videos out a day. It was just, I had to do it. She did a lot smaller than, Summer Rae, but can fly like no other. Nice springboard drop kick there. Summer Rae has not gotten anything going. And it may show that Summer Rae, getting a little nervous in championship pitcher matches. I don't think she realized that how close she is to getting there. And now Summer Rae taking advantage here. Off the rope. Oh, drop kick right to the face. And like I said, it could be that, Summer Rae is not ready for a match like this. Summer Rae maybe pushed too early. And that happens a lot in the world of wrestling. But Summer Rae's gonna try and take as much advantage as she can here. Oh, stepping around the face of Yamashita there, and now picking up Yamashita. Yamashita can barely get up. Oh, Yamashita spoke too soon. Yamashita got herself out of that. Summer Rae getting picked up here by Yamashita. You know Yamashita wants to end this one for sure. Are you kidding me? Yamashita going to the top here. Look at this. Oh! You think that you can see Yamashita was crouching down for the pin, but realized at this point that this is the last woman standing match. Ooh, bouncing off the leg. Summer Rae getting caught up again. Oh, missed the dropkick to Yamashita. And now Summer Rae taking advantage of the opportunity. And you gotta watch out for Summer Rae. I'm telling you, she is as down as she is at this point. All she needs is a small opening, and she can win this one. Oh, going after the legs there. And that could do it there for Yamashita. But Yamashita crouching herself back up. And that'd be a good strategy for Summer Rae, is to go after the legs of Yamashita here. Oh, chopped again to the chest, off the rope, kick to the side of that. Three finishing moves says to me that she's looking to change the landscape of the Divas division forever. Yamashita picking up that ladder. This has been so exhausting. Only bad things can happen when a ladder's in the ring, and that table we saw explode a moment ago. And Summer is fucking hurt. Oh. No, Yamashita, what are you doing? What are you doing? Yamashita ready to fly. No way. Oh! Did you see that? What the fuck? What the fuck was... She flew so far. Oh! She fucking bounced off the fucking table and just like clunked off it. It was fucking crazy. I was so hyped for it too. I was like, yeah, it's gonna be sick. Sixth spot. Guess not. Sixth spot, guess not. Now Summer Rae trying to figure out what she has to do. Summer Rae Yamashita getting back up here. And that, after what she just took, I can't believe she's still standing at this point. Yamashita's feeling it. Look at this. Another kick to the chest here. This match may not be as hype as I want it to be, but I wasn't expecting also to be a fucking last woman standing match. This is fucking weird. Somebody had things going for a moment. Yamashita turning it around. Turning it in her favor here. Look at this. Oh my goodness. Now just beating the hell out of Summer with that fucking baseball bat. And you know Yamashita's got to be pissed off. Yamashita throwing everything at Summer Rae so far here in this match. And this match is fucking out of control here. Yamashita now tossing over the rope. And you know when she sets up for this, what she has in mind here. Yamashita blends in perfectly with the ring. Like, this is crazy. Oh, shit! You know that Summer's hurt at this point, and she has to figure out something. If she's still in it at this point, I'm sure what I'm trying to say. If she's still in it, she has to figure out what she has to do. Oh! Reverse that. Oh, Enziguri, but getting caught right back off guard again. And Yamashita still taking control of this match. This match has gone on for a while now. And these two, falling right over that step there. Oh, right off the side, and you saw Yamashita just splash off that fucking step there. That was nasty. That was nasty, ladies and gentlemen. What the hell did we just see? Summer Rae just smashing her with that fucking... I thought the thing was glitch for a second. I was like, what's going on? Oh, kick right to the face. Look at this. Oh, snap suplex. And Yamashita's still getting up again. Oh! Oh! Oof. Oof. Yamashita taking advantage. Oh, getting tossed over there. Summer Rae. Summer Rae saw the opportunity. She's catching. Oh, and that punch right to the head. And this may be where Summer Rae needs to get herself back into this here. Because right now, she's not doing too damn well for herself. Referee going outside to check on Yamashita to see if she's okay. And man, she looks a little hurt. But Yamashita right back up. Yamashita's listening to those counts. And what you can do in this match. Especially if you're an experienced veteran like Yamashita is, you know, kind of fake it. Fake it to make it, you know what I mean? Knowing that she has the time to rest on the outside there, taking her time, waiting for the referee to come outside and check. And that's all you gotta do sometimes in a match like this. But you also gotta think that Summer Rae is also, enjoying herself on the inside, catching her breather on the inside as well. Look at this. Oh! So, Yamashita throwing everything into this match. Oh my goodness. And again, just picking up Summer Rae, not giving her a chance to even get down here. Look at this cravat suplex. Oh my gosh, she bounced right off the mat and off that baseball bat at the same time. And now Yamashita just smacking her around with that baseball bat again. Jesus. Jeez. This match is fucking out of control. Yamashita tossing over the rope there again. Yamashita, how many times has Yamashita tossed Summer Rae over the rope? Oh! And now Yamashita taking advantage of this. What is she set up for? Look at this! Oh, moonsault going blazing right over the chest of Summer Rae. And Yamashita again with those. Oh! Almost with her with that chair there. Oh! Summer Rae does not even know what's hitting her at this point. And again with that chair. Oh, grim for the legs, and that'd be a good, like I said, going back again to the legs of Yamashita. Smart idea, and Summer Rae now taking advantage. Oh! Like I said, Summer Rae taking a lot of damage in this match, which shows the resiliency to still be fighting at this point. Look at this! Oh, again, just getting gutted like a fish on those fucking steps. Summer Rae taking advantage. And the good girl. Oh, shit. Summer Rae backing away from Yamashita. This is a little new. Or at least getting herself into the ring. I don't think she realizes that. What her plans are. Like I said, maybe in this match a little too early. I know this sounds crazy, but when it comes to experience, you're going in with Yamashita. Yamashita ready to throw hand bones there. Oh, clicking her right on you. I don't know if you heard it. It was the slightest click, and she may have hit something hard there on Yamashita. No! Dude! I don't even know how that made sense. They should have super kicked the chair in her face. Yamashita, oof! Oh, no. Yamashita setting up. Oof! What the hell is Yamashita thinking here? Sometimes it seems like the crowd's not even behind Yamashita at this point. Look at this! Oh my goodness! The crowd saying this is awesome regardless of who's winning or losing at this point. They know this match is out of control, but also Yamashita carrying this match a lot in her favor. She knows she has to keep this championship. Doof! Hitting her right out of the air. She caught her with the elbow there, believe it or not. Summer Rae ready to take advantage for sure here. It's that little crash, that slight crash that may do it. Oh, and Yamashita getting herself back up again. Oh, taking that shot right to the back. And Summer Rae getting things going. Oh, and a kick right to the head. Oh, right on that fucking mat again, just smashing her head into the mat here. And this could be it here. Summer Rae may have this one in the bag. Look at this. Showstopper landed the long legs right across the chest. And Yamashita right back up. Oh. Head scissors taking her down. I don't know what Yamashita has planned, but that would, when she has a fucking ladder like that set up, can't be good. Oh! Dove! Oh, and the ladder landed right on her there. But yeah, with Summer Rae moving out the way, but I don't know if she has a lot in her. Oh my god, no! Oh my goodness! That could be it right there, and Summer Rae may be out of it. Bouncing head right off that fucking ladder, and Summer Rae fucking walked right into that trap that Yamashita set up. This is only our first match tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Mayhem's gonna get out of fucking control. And it is at this point. Look at this. Oh my goodness, Summer Rae is taking so much damage in this match and still getting up, ladies and gentlemen. I don't know how the girl's doing it, but she is fucking phenomenal. Oh my gosh, Hurricanrana again on the fucking ladder. Did I say steps before? I'm gonna say ladder. Sorry. Anyway. Again, another one, and letting her on the referee there. Yamashita feeling it, but you gotta think that she has a little bit of hurt in her. As much as she's showing off here, she's gotta be in pain. Shawn needs Summer Rae to get up here. Summer Rae getting up. Oh my gosh, put right back in again. Yamashita. Oh, Summer Rae reversal. Look at this. Neckbreaker taking her down. Yamashita's still fighting. Summer Rae still fighting. Surprisingly, oh, a super kick may do it. A super kick may do it right there. Yamashita going to the top here. And you gotta believe she's hurt, but she's still going for big moves like this. Another moonsault she landed at that time. You gotta think. That there's something that's gotta give in this match. These girls wanted this match so much. These girls want to win that championship so much. And at this point, it could be out. It could be done here for Summer Rae. And Summer Rae getting right back up. And that might not be a good idea. I don't think she knows what's behind her. Oh! Referee even cringing there. That was a hard hit. God damn it. Messed it up. Messed up the spot. Nope. Everything that's transpired thus far, it's been so physical. You're right about that, Cole. This has been an No. Yamashita. Oh my goodness. That's fall. That fall is not good for Yamashita. And Yamashita could be out of it at this point here. Now it's gut check time. This has been so exhausting. Yamashita is damn near battered and beaten at this point. What's gotta give? Oh! Yamashita right back up. Summer Rae can't believe it. These two are bringing it to each other here at this point. And I can't believe that Summer Rae is still fighting, like I said before, again and again and again. But the girl's resilient. And no, she's not getting enough credit for what she does here. Oh my goodness. No. Oh my gosh. Oh. Caught in the ladder. There's no way she's getting up. I think she's actually caught in the ladder. And Yamashita showing no remorse here. That was a nasty hole. And look at her. She's hurt. She is hurt. It's been so physical. You're right about that, Cole. This has been an all-out war. Summer may be out of it. Oh my gosh, Summer getting back up here somehow, some way. Summer, oh! Choking her out here. Something's gonna give. One of these two have to just hit one big time move and finish the whole damn thing. Oof. Reversal there by Summer Rae. Summer Rae could have this one. Oh. Uh-oh. Look at this. No. Crockpot. Oh, my gosh. Over the table. Over the ladder. And landed right now with such a horrible spot. What the hell is the referee doing? Oh, shit. The referee just smashed her with a fucking... Yo, the referee's in cahoots with Yamashita. What's going on? What's going on? This is a conspiracy. Is the referee in cahoots with Yamashita? This is the wackiest match I've ever fucking had in a while. And Summer's still getting up. Summer's still getting up. Oh, right again. Right to the face of Summer Rae. Yamashita.
Three, four, five. I can't believe everything that's transpired thus far. It's been so physical. You're right about that, Cole.
That baseball bat to the face may have done it. Summer, and Summer's still getting back up. I may have spoke too soon. Go right to the face. And Summer is knocked the hell out for stunned for a moment. Look at this. Oh, jeez. What's up with these glitches? This match is weird. And I know if this is a last man standing match, I know I'm going to have more. I'm thinking of ways to, like, oh, really overdo it next fucking time. Oh, no. No, Yamashita, what are you doing? Oh, my goodness. That could be it right there. That could be it right there. Summer could be out of it.
She's going to need to dig down deep if she wants to keep going now.
I'm sorry this match has gone so long, ladies and gentlemen, but man, this is out of fucking control here. You talk about hatred between these two. That hatred just came to a powerbomb and smashing the back of Summer Rae into the table, and Summer Rae still getting up. I'm thinking Summer Rae knows where she's at right now. Oh my gosh, the AP cross. That could be it right there for sure.
The officials count it again. Will it be for the last time?
I'm thinking Yamashita can't even think of anything else to even pull off at this point. Summer, it looks like she's trying to get back up here. What the hell? Did you see that? What a win here for Yamashita, but what a fucking wacky match to start this off. I'm sorry, guys. That match could have been so much better. But Summer Rae wasn't even trying to fight. I don't know what's going on. She didn't try to really put any effort into it. I like more than likely, I was hurting myself, doing more damage to myself than I was, like, than Summer Rae was doing to me, which is so fucking weird. Like, I don't know why she didn't try. And it sucks because she fucking put so much work in those cutscenes and everything, like, all weeks before. She was bringing it to me. Like, I actually was feeling a little bit of a challenge, you know? But I don't know what happened tonight. And then at the end here, what the fuck? I did my taunt, but it was not what I expected. You know, Yamashita holding that championship for another month there. Doing a great job holding that championship.
And there's your winner, ladies and gentlemen. It's wins like that that makes this diva such a force to be reckoned with.
I don't know what happened. I'm sorry, guys. That was fucking weird. Hopefully these next matches can start speeding up a little bit. But up next, the Pure Intense Wrestling Intercontinental Championships on the line. DDP will be defending that championship up next. So get ready for it. It's going to get out of control. Only at Mayhem. Triple threat match for the Pure Intense Wrestling Intercontinental Championship. And Rusev recently added into this match. Weird enough. Rusev winning his match earlier this week against Roman Reigns and Baron Corbin. Oh! R-Truth earning his shot against DDP. Wasn't expecting to have a triple threat. I actually wasn't expecting to have a triple threat until it actually popped up. And I said, hey, this is actually be a pretty cool match to have these three going on. Oh, this is a triple threat match. So best believe these three guys are going to fucking bring it. There are no disqualifications. No countouts. Only pinball submissions can win this one. Oh. Back and forth here. Oh. You saw R-Truth going over a rolling elbow there. Look at this. Oh my god. I don't know if. Was that a German suplex? I don't know what it was, but it was nasty. Oh. Gutting like a fucking fish with that fucking sledgehammer there. Oh my gosh, that fucking face, kind of face busted there. Oof. Oh, he just backhanded him. Oh, and got caught right the end of the sledgehammer hit Rusev right in the face. That could knock him out for sure there. But Rusev, a tough motherfucker, getting himself back up. Man, he's hurt. That definitely did it. Look at this here. Oh, using that leverage that DDP has there. The height advantage definitely going into the favor of DDP here. Oh, clothesline taking down R-Truth. It would have been R-Truth and just DDP one-on-one. But like I said, this match may be just as better. Oh, than anything else that I could have thought of, that at least the AI could have thought of. I think it was a pretty good thing being put together. Oh my gosh, and right now Rusev being dominant in this match, and as dominant as DDP is, he's taking a lot of damage here in this match, just as much as R-Truth has. They're beating the hell out of DDP. They know if they can take out DDP, then they can definitely at least have a chance. Oh, and I went in this damn thing here. Oof. Look at this. Oh. One for the pin here on DDP, referee. Two. Only two. Kicking out of it, two there, DDP. Oh, missing that clothesline. Forearm shot. Oof. Oh, clothesline taken. Taken. DDP over here for sure. Oh, my goodness. Oh, missed the super kick. R2 taking advantage of that opportunity now. Look at this. Look at this. Here you go. Look at this. Running power slam, Oklahoma. DDP taking advantage of that with that fucking spinning power bomb. We just saw the same thing from Yamashita. And he could have this one, referee. And oh, and kicking out at two. Did R2 or did Rusev save him? We'll never know. Oh, my goodness. Look at this. Oh, super kick taking him down. And that could be it there for fucking R-Truth, though. The thing about it, Rusev is, his finishers are not exactly, quick and easy. If R-Truth hits you with a fucking little jimmy, it's over. You know what I mean? If DDP hits you with a diamond cutter, it's over. But Rusev has to finish it off with the accolade there. Not saying that he can't win the match any other way, but right now I think the accolades are one of his strongest things to go for. Big time body splash right on the chest of Rusev. R-Truth setting up for something big. Look at this leg drop, and you see DDP was setting up for that diamond cutter there, and Rusev right back up, fighting himself out of this one here. Rusev now outside of the ring. You gotta watch. Oh, both R-Truth and DDP. DDP was definitely gonna, looks like he was setting up. Oh, like he was gonna set up for the diamond cutter. And you gotta, like I said, gotta watch these guys. Look at this. DDP tossing the big man. Oh my gosh. With everything that he had into that barricade there. DDP tossing Rusev back into the ring. And as big as Rusev is, he takes so much time to get up there. DDP, got caught up there. Going after the back of R-Truth there, and that's a good idea. Getting this accolade in quick. Setting it in quick, but DDP makes the save. DDP going for the pinfall here. Breaking it up there. Oof. Reversal there by DDP. I think DDP was set up with the diamond cutter. Rusev's side coming. Oh, and he cut him off quick. R-Truth setting up. Look at this. Oh, he got him. Truth and Conviction, I believe that's what it's called. And he got him with that one. That could be it right there. Referee, but DDP's up. I don't think he realizes it. DDP makes a save. Oh, Rusev with a punch right to the gut there. And trying to get himself up, but R-Truth seen it coming and got him with a suplex off the ground. And that shows the strength of R-Truth. R-Truth, the veteran in the ring, just as much as DDP or Rusev is. I think when it comes down to it, DDP would be the first veteran here. R-Truth being the second, Rusev being the third. Backhand. At this point, if you're in the ring with Diamond Dallas Page,
You have to be on constant alert for the diamond cutter.
Look at this. Oh my gosh. Uranagi. One-armed fucking spine buster there. I can't fucking look at. Oh shit. You saw fucking DDP do that earlier to Rusev. Rusev learning in this match as well. And our DDP kicking out a fucking two there, but very close three, and that could have done it. Oh, jeez, that bicycle kick may have done it right there as well. DDP setting up, reverse DDT taking him down.
A wild overhead punch wreaking havoc in here. No kidding, that shot came out of nowhere. Whoa, a direct hit.
Rusev wants to win this Intercontinental Championship, but so does R-Truth, and DDP wants to keep it. I think of all the times, that DDP has been in championship matches having that Intercontinental Championship. He's never been a triple threat, I don't believe, if I'm not mistaken. And DDP now may be in trouble here. Oh, we're kicking out at two again, using that strength that he has there. Getting to the ropes, and I think Rusev pushed. No, I can't even close on him. What the fuck? Anyway, I think Rusev pushed R-Truth. Oh! Into the ropes, saving DDP. Oh! And now going. DDP setting up. Big time. Clothesline taking down Rusev. And this could be it here, ladies and gentlemen, right here on Rusev referee. R-Truth making that save there because he wants to have this match for himself. DDP setting up some big. Reverse mat slam, taking Rusev down again, and now DDP going for the pin here on our Rusev here, referee, and R-Truth saving it again. R-Truth wants that championship shot. He wants that championship victory. He may have it here, big time. Fucking damn, it's probably cord buster. Oof. Oh, saving himself there. Oh, clubbing him as he came down. And Rusev very quick at getting quick pot shots, but when he gets going, he can get strong. He gets fucking throwing him. Oh! Toss him around like the best. Now go for the Uranagi on Diamond Dallas Page. Big time. Big time move there. And I think Rusev knows what it's time for, but R-Truth also knows what it's time for. R-Truth setting up. Oh my goodness. And R-Truth may have this one. Ladies and gentlemen, this match could be over here. Referee. And R-Truth with a victory. R-Truth holding an Intercontinental Championship. Holy shit. We saw Rusev and fucking R-Truth beat the hell out of DDP in the early going. DDP trying to make a comeback at the end of it. R-Truth with a big time victory here, though. Definitely showing that he can go in with the best of them. And throwing around Rusev and DDP like he is the veteran in this ring. Holy shit. R-Truth with a big time victory. And right there, Rusev with not enough stamina to get himself back into this. It was enough time. You saw him stirring at right here at the one count, but just wasn't enough. And like I said, beating the hell out of DDP early on was a good idea because it set up for such a great move like that. And perfect timing here for R-Truth. And R-Truth now holding that Intercontinental Championship. What a win here for R-Truth, ladies and gentlemen. What a win
for
R-Truth. But up next, some tag team matching for your asses. Are you ready for it? Let's do this. Congratulations, R-Truth. Your new Pure Intense Wrestling Intercontinental Champion. Good shit. Playing as Adeo, Tommy, and Neville as they take on Sin Cara and Kalisto. Oh, and already Sin Cara throwing his weight around here in this match. Experience definitely has to go to Hideo, Tommy, and Neville. But Kalisto and Sin Cara are very good in the ring as well. Kalisto very experienced in the ring in the indies. Much like Neville. I'm pretty sure they've met before. Sin Cara back in doing his thing back in Mexico as well. Oh!
Tell us about Neville.
Well, luckily the body hasn't absorbed too much of an attack up to the...
Swatted away quick and easy. Oh! This is what I'm talking about, changing the pace here. I'm sorry about, like I said, sorry about the first match, but the pace has definitely now changed since then. And everything's flying now. Congratulations to R-Truth becoming the new Pure Intense Wrestling Intercontinental Champion. He'll be defending that just about every week, just like every other minor title. Oh! But no title is seriously minor in the end, because it always leads to bigger things. Already here with a shooting star press right on the chest of Sin Cara, and this could be it. Referee counting it. One, two, oh. And I will promise you this, ladies and gentlemen, that the tag team division will be turned up to a fucking higher notch soon enough. Right now, these teams trying to figure each other out, but right now, I mean, just all it takes, another shooting star press, we're landing knees right into the back of Sin Cara. Sin Cara not able to turn over. The receiver was trying to get up, and Neville went in too early, and Sin Cara now is hurt. He's a tag in. Ooh. He's a tag in. Kalisto gets something going for this team. Right now, he is hurt.
A lot of things can go wrong there. Well, that messed him all right.
Oh, standing C fire taking down Neville, and that's what I mean right here. You gotta use someone like Kalisto, who's a lot quicker. Oh! Setting up! Kick to the chest, and you can see both teams as well wearing their team colors here. And the Neville agreeing to wear the yellow. Much like Hideo.
Looking fresh out there. You're not going to lose any matches when you're competing at full.
No! Oh, landing right on the fucking back of his head there, did Neville. After that fucking side suplex. Back suplex. Landing on the back of the head there. Going for the pin. Neville kicking right at one. Simple and easy. Neville's still in it. Drop kick to the back of Neville, right to the back of the head of Neville, actually. And Kalisto now has things going for his team. And it's sometimes just a tag away. That's all you need. Oh my goodness! Fucking Shining Wizard. Saw Kalisto trying to distance himself, see how much space he had to hit to get for that bounce. And I think if he actually had a little more speed there, if he did it from another angle, he maybe would have got a three. But so close, it's so hard to get a move that's so great like that. With such a momentum, and you know, especially when you have none, but Kalisto very quick at getting momentum, even if he's not bouncing off the rope. That's what makes him so great. Him and Sin Cara can move like fucking speed demons for sure, I promise you that. And Neville needs to get something going for his team, but right now, oh, Kalisto with that fucking side kick to the head. Kalisto kick, the Listo kick, I think as they call it. Referee, one, two, oh, and Neville kicks out at two, but very close. Very close. I don't think Neville and Hideo have been in this much trouble in a while here. Looking up, setting him up for something big. Look at this, going for the pin, trying to go for the simple pin here. Referee. No, and Neville kicks out again. Oh.
What a match this is gonna be.
You see, it's Sin Cara beating the hell out of Hideo Itami on the outside. Oh, smack to the chest. Kalisto using that cruiserweight status there to throw around Neville. And as quick as Neville is, Kalisto's just as quick. And now,
and the ref starts to count. He's in big trouble. Neville is making it.
It's one simple grab like that. That's all he took. That's all it took for Neville to set up for something big and get himself back in this simple and easy suplex. Going for the pin right on the chest of Kalisto there. No, Kalisto kicking out at two. Kalisto's still fresh in this, but he's putting a lot of stamina into staying into this one. Neville not done by any means. Gonna tag in. The hell is in him? Oh! Oh my goodness! Are you kidding me? Neville just damn near killed him there. I don't know why Neville has that when he doesn't need to have that. Hideo going to the top here. Look at this! Oh! I wish that Neville didn't do that. Fucking idiot.
strike. That'll send a message to your adversary, all right.
Right in the
middle. Oh my gosh, no, brainbuster on the outside.
Kalisto may be only 5'6", but he seems to have no problem hanging with the bigger competition here in the WWE.
He's 5'6", it's because he's standing on a phone book, but his lightning fast pace that disorients the opposition, that's what is impressive. And I can't tell you how many times I've already seen the guys twice the size in the ring.
For that fucking leg drop there.
You just can't catch up.
Trying to go for the legs. Oh, Kalisto now tag, trying to tag in Sin Cara, I believe. No. Hideo not letting it happen. I'm sorry, Neville not let it happen. We're getting them. Now they're both same color and I'm losing my mind. Hideo in this one. Hideo's wanted to be in this one for a while now. And look at Hideo go. Oh, him and Neville. Oh my gosh, those kicks. And if I don't think anyone kicks as hard as Hideo with Tommy. In the history of history. Oh my goodness. Like I said, speaking for itself right there. Oh. Oh, dropkick right to the fucking, right to the arm there. I didn't even know he got him in the arm, but whatever. Showing that the accuracy that he wanted to go for wasn't, oh, exactly accurate, but that kick to the head was accurate, though. Oh, my goodness. Did you see that? He hit him so hard. Oh, draped him right over the rope there. Hideo, Tommy going to the top. Ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be over here for, oh, one for the double foot stomp. Sin Cara getting tagged in now by Kalisto. Hideo. Oh, right to the side of the head. And that could be it right there, ladies and gentlemen. Holy shit. What a move. What a move. What a move. Tagging Neville. And that's what he needs to do. If they want to get anything going, they need to keep each other fresh. Look at this. Kick to the side of the head. Look at this. Oh, my goodness. It's flying here. Neville ready to fly. Drop kick to the side of the head. Dropping him between the legs and now hitting the temple, the top right to the head. Oh. Look at this. Oh, right to the chest. Fucking corkscrew moonsault, I believe. Neville setting up. Using that strength. Oh, to toss him into the rope there. Championships are on the line, and then Neville and Hideo are trying to keep those things. But right now, Sin Cara and Kalisto are bringing it. Like I said, maybe the toughest challenge for Hideo and Neville so far.
This match just keeps getting better.
Neville is trying to get himself back up here. And like I said, taking a lot of damage in this match. And needs to get something going. Needs to get something going. Oh, spinning back kick right there. That just may be the opening that he needs there to tag in Neville. I mean, sorry, Hideo and Hideo. Reversal again, saw it coming a mile away. Oh my goodness. Neville just needs to tag in Hideo and keep this thing going. Oh! Hideo, oh my gosh, those knees. Look at this. Oh, missed the fucking... Uh-oh. Watch Kalisto. Kalisto's gonna set up something big. Kalisto's setting up something big here, ladies and gentlemen. Look at this. Frankenstein from the top. This match is still going on. What a match this is. Referee. Oh, only a one count there. Hideo's showing that resiliency. Oh! Hideo. Look at this. Oh, he got him with the GTS. Oh, I thought that was it. Kick to the face.
And there's the tag. Neville into the ring.
Neville's getting himself into the ring here. This could be bad here. We've seen this before, ladies and gentlemen. We've seen this before. Oh, he missed it. He missed the fucking... Look at this. He can win this here. One, two, no. Oh, kick to the side of the leg there. Neville's still up. But taking a lot of damage here. Look at this. German suplex got him.
Oh man, you take a shot like that and you feel it for weeks, even if you can get back to your
He is hurt. You best believe that both these teams are hurt. Oh my gosh, he's not going to do it. Look at him. He has no strength left. He's still pulling off this deadlift German suplex. Crowd is on their feet for both these teams. They know that they both deserve to have this championship. These championships around their waist, but only one team come out ahead. Oh, backbreaker there. Spinning back kick just like Neville did. Oh my goodness, that kick. Kalisto can hardly stand at this point. He needs to tag in Sankara and get something going for the team. Oh, kick to the head. Clothesline taking over Sankara. We saw earlier Sankara beating the hell out of Hideo here on the opposite side. And now double foot stomp to the chest. Oh, running like a drive-by there. That clothesline was nasty. Ladies and gentlemen, this is only our third match of the night. Up next, we'll see some Divas action. This is Mayhem. Both. It's a joint hosting. So we'll see both Pure Intense Wrestling and Divas. Like you've seen before in the first match. Clothesline taken over. Kalisto again here, and Hideo needs to keep that on his team right now. He's getting something going. This is what I'm talking about here. Oh. Both teams are watching here in the middle of this ring. Oh, Kalisto definitely feeling the kicks there.
People have been wanting to see these guys go at it for a long time, and by the sound of this crowd,
looks like he's set up for the GTS. Looks like he's set up for the GTS here, and this could be it. He got him. They got the victory. Holy shit. It's hard to end a tag team match because you're like, yeah, they don't. It's not the same. It's not the same at all. Why did the game slow down here? What the hell? Okay. Back and forth between these two teams. We saw the usual setup that Hideo and Neville usually set up for, but I think Neville didn't have enough energy in him after taking the beating from both Sinkar and Kalisto to go for that the red arrow. After Hideo set him up after the go to sleep.
Let's go to the highlights here.
But it wasn't until the end of it here where he got the GTS and got the victory. But what a win for both these! What a win for Hideo and Neville. But best believe that the tag team division is going to turn up in a little bit. But right now, everyone's finding that spot. The Action Championships. That's what I'm talking about. The Pure Intense Wrestling Action Championships. Oh, man. I sound like I'm fucking crazy, I know. But it's only because this fucking game is going out of this fucking mind. Anyway, guys, up next, some Divas action for your asses. Get ready for it. But congratulations to Neville and Hideo for keeping those championships for another week or another month or whatever. I'll see you guys in the next episode. Shit, what am I talking about? See you guys in the next match. What's up next? Get ready for it.